believe in yourself, not in the Simone I believe in, not in the Kamina that you believe in. Have faith in the Simone that believes in you. Kamina, Gurren Lagann. Yeehaw, soldiers. It's your boy, the Anime Sage, coming at you for another video, and this is with Naruto Had the Spiral Power Part 1. In the wake of me finishing Otsutsuki Naruto, here's a new series which will include a great power from Gurren Lagann, Spiral Power. Now before we get into this, the usual stuff, watch my community tab at Gahawk, join my Patreon, follow me on Twitch, Twitter, @AnimeStage4, Instagram, @Anime_Stage4, and join my Discord server, all of which are in the description. I will give you all reason to follow slash join the latter free at the end of the video, so watch until the end. In terms of videos coming up, stay tuned for a new Legacy chapter video. I believe it's going to be Legacy 38 for 40. And after that, maybe expect Soul Leveling Deku soon and some other stuff in between. And finally, if you have any fanfics you think I should read for my channel, be it Naruto, MHA, DBC, or something else, or One Piece, of course, comment down above the name of the fanfic and leave a link to it so I can read it. And also, shout out to my boy Drew for editing this video. Since it's a new series, we can get right into this, so let's get into the story. Alright, so first, what is Spiral Power? Because some of you guys might not be familiar with it because you might not have watched Gurren Lagann, or you did and you didn't really understand it. So Spiral Power is essentially a power used by most notably the main character of Gurren Lagann, Simone. It is the power that allows him to do a lot of insane feints, or to more exact, to do the impossible. And one of those feats includes punching an anti-spiral Mugen through the space-time continuum. Yes, that happened. The power comes from one's emotions, particularly the will to never give up. I wonder who that reminds me of. The best part of spiral power is used by beings who can use it, such as humans and animals, though some master better than others. And now, before I fully get into this, I only have one more thing to say. Watch Gurren Lagann. Seriously, watch it, it is a masterpiece. And you will see Gurren Lagann villains because they can easily be incorporated into the world of Naruto. So again, watch Gurren Lagann. Alright, now let's officially get into the story. In a world of shinobi, there's power amongst every being that very few can master. This is Spiral Power, a power that can do the impossible. And a power that has not been used in a very long time. To the point it has now been forgotten. This is the story of a shinobi who was able to use the spiral power and change the world forever, going up against many threats in not only his world, but the entire multiverse. This is the story of Naruto Uzumaki. Naruto is a young boy who has grown up wanting to become a shinobi. No, not just any shinobi, but the Hokage of his village. People have looked down him for a while though because he's in Shirk of the Nine Tails. That and also his dreams seem ridiculous because he kind of sucks at being a ninja. However, something is about to change, for better or for worse. Naruto is running away from some ninja because he decided to prank them. Naruto travels a bit too far from the village and is now inside the woods. Along the way, Naruto trips on one of the branches and then falls to the ground. He then encounters a cave as he gets up and wonders how he ended up here. Oh well, I might as well see what is inside this cave, Naruto says to himself. Naruto then heads to the cave and he sees something unique. It seems to be a box. Naruto takes a look at the box and wonders if he can open it, but to no avail. Naruto then notices a hole. Naruto thinks it might be the keyhole and it looks like something can fit inside there. Naruto then sees his necklace that he wears glow. The necklace that he wears is a memento from his parents. Naruto has no idea who those parents are because they died when he was born, but it's at least a nice memento from them. Naruto decides to stick the drill on his necklace in the keyhole, and then when he turns it, all of a sudden a bunch of green energy enters Naruto, and Naruto afterwards passes out. When Naruto wakes up, he's in the hospital and he learns he was found passed out in a cave by a search party Hiruzen sent. Naruto then tells him what happened and Hiruzen says, "But Naruto, when we got there, there was no box." Naruto's eyes widen as, how could that be possible? Hiruzen then says, "I'm gonna put trust in you for now because while you are a prankster, I doubt you would lie about this. But I definitely have my doubts about your story as it is very hard to believe. Though I don't know why else you would be passed out in a cave." Naruto nods and thanks Hokage and he will go back to his normal life. Over the next couple weeks and eventually a few months, he will get ready for graduation, and on a day of the graduation day test, he will fail. He will eventually be given a deal by Mizuki to steal a scroll, and we'll fast forward to the fight with Mizuki as Naruto learns that he's in Jinchuriki of the Ninetales, and eventually hears Iruka compliment him. As Mizuki makes a move to kill Iruka with that giant shuriken, Naruto smacks into him and pushes him back. Naruto then starts to gather green energy around him and says, "If you ever lay a hand on my sensei, I'll kill you." Then that green energy gets stronger and stronger, and then Naruto uses Shao Clone Jutsu, and his clones have that green energy around them. Iruka then has two things pop in his mind. One, Naruto learned Shao Clone Jutsu. Neat. Then two, what the hell is that green energy around him? Naruto will then smack Mizuki with that green energy he has around him, along with a bunch of his clones, and Mizuki is in a world of hurt. As usual, Naruto then power down, and Iruka decides to quickly ask Naruto what that was. Naruto tells him he has no idea what it was, but it definitely made him more powerful. Iruka will just let it be, and decides to do two things. One, graduate Naruto, and two, send him to Hokage to see if he knows anything about this energy. If he does, maybe Naruto can train to get all the techniques of this power. Alright, so I'm gonna just get this out of the way because I don't want to have to answer this question somewhere down the road. Gurren Lagann is a mecha anime meme that the characters fight in Transformer-style robots, and a lot of Simone's feats with spiral power came from him being inside a mecha. I have decided to kind of cut those out for now because I just cannot see mechas and Naruto working out together. It just doesn't feel like that holy of a mix. However, you know what can work? Avatars. Or, to be more specific, something similar to Bijuu mode for Naruto with spiral power. I will let you fill in those details, and let's just say mechas will have a bit of a role later down the line. Anyways, Naruto will have a talk with Hokage, and as Hiruzen congratulates Naruto on graduating, Iruka asks if he knows anything about the green energy that surrounded Naruto. Hiruzen unfortunately does not. All that they know so far is that it made Naruto stronger, which is something Naruto already knew since he experienced it, so the only way he can discover more uses of this power is to find out for himself. And Naruto is ready for a challenge. "I will discover all the secrets of this power, and with this power, I have a feeling I will be able to accomplish my dream of becoming Hokage. Believe it!" And with that, the adventure of Naruto will truly begin. Meanwhile, somewhere in a different world, there are beings called the Anti-Spiral, and they are led by their leader, the Anti-Spiral. They seek to end all races with spiral power because they believe spiral power will cause the end of the universe. The Anti-Spiral get word of a spiral being on the planet Earth. It appears that the society has not gotten the benefits of spiral power yet, so there is not a need to worry at the moment. However, if the society starts advancing and society thrives to the point the Earth gets to 1 million people, they will have to do something about it. And that something will include making sure they feel nothing but total despair. In the end, even if the spiral power on Earth gets stronger, it will not matter. The Earth will fall, and the spiral race there will feel nothing but despair, says the Anti-Spiral. Meanwhile, back on Earth, Naruto will be put on a team with his crush Sakura and his rival Sasuke. On the rooftop, Naruto will be asked his goals and stuff by his new sensei Kakashi, and Naruto has a slightly changed goal here, and that is to not only become Hokage, but learn the secrets of his hidden power and master it. Sasuke is both shocked and intrigued by what Naruto is saying because if he does have this hidden power that he is trying to learn and master, it might make him a more useful teammate than he thought he could be, and can make Sasuke himself stronger if he trains with Naruto a lot. Plus, in a way, they would be similar because he is trying to unlock and master his Sharingan. Sakura just thinks Naruto is lying until Kakashi reveals Naruto is telling the truth. When Sakura and Sasuke ask what it is, Naruto says he doesn't really know, but whatever it is, it makes him stronger by surrounding him with a green aura. Sasuke and Sakura wonder if he can show them, but Naruto can't because he doesn't fully know how he unlocked it in the first place. Moving on to the bell test, Naruto and company will take on Kakashi, and Naruto will fight Kakashi like in canon. Kakashi, while he wishes Naruto was high and like his teammates, will take the opportunity to see if he can push Naruto to use his power again. as he utterly just toys with Naruto, he thinks back to what Naruto said when he was telling the tale of how he unlocked his power in the first place, and thinks it might be possible that he was able to unlock it from his desire to protect his sensei from Mizuki. Kakashi then wonders if that desire can be put elsewhere besides wanting to save people. So he continues to toy with Naruto, then eventually kicks him away and Naruto's on the ground. And eventually Kakashi says, "So, is that all he can do? Is that all the power he can muster? Or are you just gonna sit there and give up and lay there? You will never become Hokage that way. Now, are you gonna get up and continue to fight, or just give up?" Naruto then says, "I will not give up. I will become Hokage, and I will beat you here!" Naruto then has the green aura surround him again, and Sasuke and Sakura are just watching, and they are in awe. Naruto then speeds towards Kakashi and catches him off guard, and Kakashi gets punched away. And Kakashi realizes he has to get serious, and he will reveal the Sharingan and will take control of the battle, eventually winning against Naruto. Sasuke thinks that he is going to need to have a talk with Kakashi about that Sharingan, though not before he and Sakura get smacked by Kakashi. And then Kakashi gets himself some rest because, yeesh, he used a lot more stamina than he ever thought he would use. Eventually, Team 7 will become a team like in canon, though this time, Sakura will get tied up because she had the worst performance out of the three, and both Naruto and Sasuke feed her so she's not hungry, and is at full strength when they face off against Kakashi again. You know the rest. Anyways, Naruto has not only just begun his journey as a ninja, but he also has begun his journey as a potential savior of not only the universe, but maybe the entire multiverse. Will he be ready for what's to come, or will he fail due to the pressure? Find out in the next part, and as the story continues. Thank y'all for watching part 1 of what if Naruto had the spiral power. I really, really love Gurren Lagann, and I really, really, really love the premise and everything about the story so far, and I hope you guys enjoy this story going forward as I continue writing it. And one more thing I wanted to do here, I want to shout out Alex the Gurren Lagann guy, a guy that I know very well on Twitter. I want to thank him for not only, you know, being supportive of my channel, but also for telling me to watch Gurren Lagann, because I did not regret the decision. So yeah. Anyways, in terms of the usual stuff, get ready for Legacy Chapters 38 through 40, and also get ready for Solo Leveling Deku Part 2, so stay tuned for that. If you have any suggestions for fanfics I should read, be it Naruto, MHA, DBC, or One Piece, comment down the name of it down below and link to where I can read it. Watch my community tab like a hawk, that's important. And finally, follow my Twitter for an way to get notified of my videos, as well as the best place to interact with me since I'm very active on Twitter, which is probably not a good thing, but yeah. Follow me on Twitter at MSH4, and follow me on Instagram, MA_SH4, for memes and just memes. And I might respond to the occasional DM if I have the time. And finally, join me on Discord server for my second most active platform, and in order to get notified of my videos and some other stuff in between. So again, join me on Discord server, which is linked down in the description. These are all great ways for you guys to interact with me, so follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and join me on Discord server. Shout out to our patrons, their names on screen, and my $50 patron Anguish, and my $50 patron Gabe Tidwell. If you want to support me further and get rewards or shouts like these, go to my Patreon, which is linked in the description. We're getting closer to 48 and eventually 50k, so let's get there. And that's all I have to say. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, turn on notifications, share the video. This has been your boy, the Anime Sage. Sign out. Peace. Yorha. 70 Shade closes out. Bye bye. Peace.